Welcome back to our lecture series in linear control system. So in today's class we were discussing about effect of adding a pole or zero to an existing system. So till the moment we know how to draw a root locus diagram, how we can comment about the stability by varying the k, by checking the locus. If the entire locus is at the left side, system is stable. If some portion of locus is moving towards right side, system will become unstable for those values of k. So we completed those portions in last class, and today we are checking what happens if you are adding one more pole or one more zero. So as a first topic, we are discussing about poles only, addition of poles, what effect it will make there. So first of all, you have to keep this in mind: by adding poles, stability will reduce. I will show these things. Stability will reduce and entire root locus diagram will shift to right side. Both the statements are same. If root locus is going towards right side, then stability will reduce. If points are more left, it is more stable. If the points are coming towards right side, chances are more for getting unstable. If it is on marginally imaginary axis, it is critically stable. If we move further right, system will become unstable. If we move a little bit left, system will become stable. That is marginally stable or margin stable condition. So first of all, you have to keep this thing: by adding pole, anyhow the root locus diagram will shift towards right and stability will reduce. We will check how. So if you are having this question in exam, you have to write this statement and then you have to show with an example. That is the better way. And by using this way, by taking an example, your concept will become more clear. So this is the first case. We are considering a second order system, 1 by s into s plus 1. So order of s time in the denominator is 2, so second order system. So it will be having number of poles is 2. Which are the poles? S is equal to 0 and s is equal to minus 1. These are the two poles. Okay, let me draw the root locus diagram. So initially this is imaginary axis and this is real axis. Sorry, this is a real axis and this is imaginary axis, and s is 0, first pole is marked here, and s is equal to minus 1, second pole is marked here. So this is a very simple case. Everybody know root locus exists only if number of poles and zeros to the right side is odd number. So if you are considering any section here to the right side, it is odd number. If you consider a section here to the right side, the total number of poles plus zero is even. So root locus will not exist. So it is very clear, in between 0 and 1 on the real axis, root locus exists. But it is completed? No, because both the elements are poles. So one branch will start from here and one branch will start from here. They will meet at the center point. Why it is center point? Because here only these two elements are present. If some other pole is there, it will not be in the center point. And if you are having doubt, you can calculate differential of d by ds of 1 by s into s plus 1, s square plus s, and equate that value to 0. You will get two values. In that, one value will be definitely 0.5 and the other value will be some invalid point. Among the two, only one value will come in between 0 and minus 1. Sorry, it is minus 0.5. So some value will come in between 0 and minus 1, that will be a valid point. If you want, you can calculate. Otherwise, if only two poles are present and root locus exists in between that two points, then definitely the point will be breakaway point, will be center point 0.5. Please keep in mind, if there is one more pole or zero, this will not be valid. You have to check, definitely you have to check, because that effect also will come in the equation. Now the effect is only in between 0 and minus 1. So if you differentiate and find the solution, it will be definitely 0.5. So now 0.5 is the center point. In that point, breakaway happens. Breakaway happens means, okay, before that breakaway, we have to mark the asymptote centroid settings. So I will come into this point. Before that, let me systematically do this. First of all, we are having the difference between poles and zero. Number of zeros is no stem in the numerator, so number of zeros is zero. So P minus Z is equal to 2. That is two poles and no zero. So two asymptotes will be there. What is the role of asymptotes? They will lead you to the direction to infinity. So you have to draw two asymptotes. So this is the equation for angles of asymptote. Theta L is equal to 2L plus 1 into pi by P minus Z. So substitute L is equal to 0 for finding theta 0, first asymptote angle. And substitute L is equal to 1 to find theta 1. So you will get two asymptotes. One is plus 90, other one is minus 90. On the symbol method, I will suggest you, if there is two asymptotes, don't need to substitute these things. You have to write this, but the final answer will be plus 90 and minus 90. If three asymptote, plus 60, minus 60, 180, like the leaves of a fan. If two asymptote, plus 90, minus 90. If four asymptote, it will be like this, cross mark, plus 45, minus 45, 235 and 315, I think, 235, okay, you measure it. Yeah, 235 and 315. So this is an easy way. Anyhow, I calculated angle of asymptotes, and as there is two asymptotes, they will have an intersection point that is nothing but centroid. Centroid is sum of poles. Sum of poles is 1 plus 0. Sorry, not 1, minus 1 plus 0. Minus sum of 0, no zeros are there. Divided by number of poles minus 0, 2. So you will get minus 0.5 as centroid. So this is the centroid. This is a centroid. You have to draw like this only. First asymptote is plus 90 and second asymptote is minus 90. This is the systematic way, but don't do such in detail because you know all these steps. And now you know the root locus exists in between these two poles as per rule number 7, and these two branches will initiate and meet at the center point. You calculate, you will get breakaway point, like it is also minus 0.5. So one branch will move towards the infinity like this, and other branch will move towards the infinity like this. This is the root locus diagram. So you have to check that all the branches are moving towards infinity, but it is not crossing the imaginary axis. Till the moment it is stable, it is not going to unstable region. So you can definitely write, these are the points, sigma or centroid is equal to 0.5. You have to keep these things. Before adding one pole, you have to keep what is the base condition. Sigma is equal to 0.5. So now I am coming to the conclusions of this plot. So plot is over, it's a simple plot. Now we are referring always about the centroid. So I already told you that root locus diagram shifts towards right when an extra pole is added. So now extra pole is not added. So you have to take the reference on sigma, centroid of the diagram. If some pole is more added, I have to check whether centroid moves towards left or right. As per our theory, centroid should move towards right. So now the centroid is 0.5. So if some extra pole is added, the centroid will shift towards right, means its value should get closer to 0, or its value should reduce like 0.4, 0.3, like that. So now you have to keep in mind centroid is 0.5 for this case. You know how to calculate centroid. This is the equation. And about the stability. So which are the starting points? This is one starting point, one open loop pole, and this is another starting point. So at these two points, we know k is equal to 0. Now we are gradually increasing k. So the root locus diagram starts like this and meet at the centroid, and it will break away from the breakaway point. It will move towards infinity. So at this point, k will be infinity. At this point also, k will be infinity. So poles are the starting point and zeros are the ending point, but I don't know where the zero is. It is in infinity. Now my question, what is the stability condition of this root locus diagram? If you are not viewed the last video, please go and view the last video and then come back to this session. Because initially when k is equal to 0, one pole is at the left side, it is okay, stable. But one pole is on the imaginary axis. So when k is equal to 0, system is marginally stable, because one pole is there on the imaginary axis, marginally stable. But what happened when k increases towards infinity? Gradually this pole also moves towards left side. This pole also moves towards left side. So, and this pole also moves to right side, but it will not go to the right hand side. It will meet at the breakaway point and goes towards infinity. So up to the last moment, k is equal to infinity, I am sure that these branches will not go to the right side. No crossing happens, because it is following this line, plus 90 minus 90 line. So k increases up to infinity, root locus diagram locus is always at right half plane is the region of instability, left half plane system is stable. So when k is equal to 0, there is an indication of marginal stability. But after that, when k increases, system becomes completely stable. Nothing is going towards right side. So generally speaking, we can take the system as a stable system. And anyhow, at some point of k, it is marginally stable, but the majority of time it is stable. So this is the conclusion. Keep this thing, centroid value and the stability statement, in mind. Now I am going to add an additional pole to this same system, and I will check what happens to the root locus diagram. Okay, now I am adding an additional pole, 1 by s plus 3, or s is equal to minus 3 is a pole that is going to be added in the denominator. For adding such thing, we are generally calling that procedure as development of a controller. We are going to develop some new thing. So generally, it may be a controller. Adding a pole or zero means we are trying to varying some parameter. So such things are generally performed by controllers. So this may be a controller. So I am giving a name, GC of S. And this was the normal existing system we already considered. G of S, H of S is equal to 1 by S into S plus 1. So now we are mixing these two things, existing plants, open loop transfer function and controller. So we are calling it as a plant. Controller plus existing system is known as a plant. So the new plant transfer function P of s is equal to 1 by s into s plus 1 into s plus 3. I'm just mixing the two transfer functions, Now for the controller or for the entire system or for the plant, number of poles is 1, 2, 3, 3 poles, and no s times in the denominator. So number of 0 is 0, no zeros are there, no zeros. And the values of that poles are s is equal to minus 1, minus 3 and s is equal to 0, 3 poles are there. Okay, now we are directly moving to the root locus diagram. So first step, number of asymptotes, number of poles minus number of zero. Here I am having 3 poles and no zeros. So all the 3 poles have to travel to infinity. So we need 3 asymptotes, or mathematically number of asymptotes is equal to P minus Z. Number of poles minus number of zero, 3 minus 0, that is 3. So we need 3 asymptotes. So 3 asymptotes means we need 3 angles of asymptotes. This is the equation for angle of asymptotes. 2L plus 1 pi into P minus Z. Put L is equal to 0, then you will get 60 degree. Put L is equal to 1, you will get minus 60 degree. Not like that. Put L is equal to 1, I think you may get minus 180 degree. And put L is equal to theta 0 and theta 1 and theta 2, that is the right notation. Anyhow, you will get 3 different the angles, 60, minus 60 and minus 180, not minus 180, plus 180. You please substitute and check whether it is obtaining or not. This is my point, no need to calculate this. If it is 3, it will be looking like the leaves of a fan, like this, leaves of a fan. 60, this is 60 degree. This is 180 degree from reference axis and this is minus 60 degree. So P minus Z is 3 means you will get like the leaves of a fan, 60 minus 60, 180. That's it. And if you want, you can substitute and check. So there is three asymptotes and there should be a meeting point. That point is known as centroid, sigma. So I am going to calculate that sigma. Sigma is nothing but sum of poles minus sum of zero by number of poles minus zero. So sum of poles is minus 1 minus 3. No zeros are there. Divided by number of pole minus number of zero, which is 3. The answer will be minus 1.33. You will get it. Minus 1.33. So this is the pole zero plot. I marked all the 3 poles. 0, minus 1 and minus 3. And now I am going to mark the centroid. It is somewhere here. Minus 2, okay. And the value of centroid is, this is the centroid. Minus 1.33, it is centroid. And at that centroid, I have to draw 3 asymptotes. I will use some other color, 3 asymptotes. Is plus 60, minus 60, 180. All the 3 asymptotes were drawn. Okay. So now this is the point. There is 3 poles. So 3 zeros should be there. So we drawn 3 asymptotes. 1 zero will be here in this infinity. 1 zero will be here in this infinity and 1 zero will be here in this infinity direction. But I have to complete the root locus diagram. So I will check which are the portions where root locus is present in the real axis. Towards the right side, number of poles plus zero is old, only 1. So root locus will exist here. In this session you can check. Number of poles plus 0 is 2, which is even number. So root locus will not present up to this. After this, again number of poles plus 0 is odd. So root locus will be present. So root locus will be present in this direction. Now it is very clear. For this branch, here one pole is here and it will meet its zero in infinity. So this branch is clear. And for this branch, root locus starts at both the points. So it will be having a breakaway point. And we have to calculate that breakaway point, because in previous case there was only two poles, 0 and minus 1. So breakaway point will be the central point. But here in the equation, there is 0 and minus 1 and some other pole is there. So if you are differentiating and calculating, it will not be the central point. So you have to definitely calculate. So for calculating breakaway point, I am taking the derivative of this open loop transfer function. S plus 1 into S plus 3 is closed multiplied. S square plus 4S plus 3 into S. Bracket is opened. S cube plus 4S square plus 3S. So by applying quotient rule of differentiation, we will get minus, so minus is here, minus 3S square plus 8S plus 3 divided by square of this denominator will be there. For the time being, I am not writing it. You know all these steps. So we will cross multiply and that will be equal to 0. So 3s square plus 8s plus 3, that is the equation. You solve that using calculator, you will get 3 values of s. In that, only one point will be a valid point. All the other two points will be invalid, because only one point will be a valid point. That valid point will lies in between 0 and minus 1, because breakaway happens in this region. All the other points will be invalid and they will exist outside this region. So minus 0.45 is the valid point. Here somewhere, breakaway happens here somewhere. So we can check. At this point, one pole will move towards this, like crossing the imaginary axis in the direction of asymptote, and the other will pass like this. We don't need the exact point of this crossing point. If you want that, you can apply RC stability criteria. I am not going to solve that now. Anyhow, what is the condition now? Actually, there is a small correction. Our centroid in this case is moving towards right side. Actually, in last case our centroid was 0.5, so I just want to correct that. Centroid is moving to left side. Previous case it was 0.5 and now it is 1.33, minus 1.33. Centroid move towards more left. But what about stability? That is our point. What about stability? Because the breakaway point in last case, breakaway was, in this case it is 0.45, minus 0.45. In last case it is minus 0.5. So breakaway point, that critical point, is moving towards the imaginary axis, and as a result of that, and we are having more asymptotes, and in that two asymptotes are clearly closing the imaginary axis. So this branch and this branch will move towards left side. So after these points, if we are increasing k, the system will become unstable. When k is equal to 0, what happened? K is equal to 0 means starting points. One point is, this is second point and this is third point. Two poles at left side and one pole at imaginary axis. So, what is the condition? So what is the condition? Definitely we can say no pole is there at the right side. So definitely we can say system is stable. System is not unstable, but one pole is there at the left imaginary axis means it is showing some marginal stability. Okay, anyhow, it is not unstable. But when k increases, what happens? One pole moves towards this infinity. Okay, no issue. Still it is there in left. But two poles are moving towards right side. When k increases to infinity, what happens? Two poles moves to right half plane. Critical. System is if any pole of closed loop transfer function is there at right side, means system is unstable. So k is equal to infinity means it represents, in last class we discussed well about that topic. K is equal to infinity means it represents poles of closed loop transfer function. Poles of closed loop transfer function when the value of k is increased to infinity. So that pole lies at the right half side. So system is unstable. So what happened? When we are adding some simple poles to the standard system, the centroid moves towards left side, but breakaway point moves towards more left, whereas breakaway point is moving towards right side, and the system is crossing imaginary axis. So system will become unstable. So generally speaking, stability reduces, or the entire root locus diagram shifts towards right when we are adding poles, and stability reduces. So this is the point. So you have to remember this question as an example, 1 by s into s plus 1, and add s plus 2 or s plus 3 some pole, and you have to show these things briefly if such a question is asked. Don't have to do the all things like breakaway point, such things are not needed. You have to just draw this shape, and you can say this is crossing. Going towards left means system is unstable, like that. You have to do like that only. So in the next class, we will discuss effect of adding zero, and by that we will come to the end of this module. So hope you enjoyed this video. You can ask the doubts by mail or call. So we'll see in the next class. Thank you.